as you can see, I have a new wig on. I wasn't sure if I wanted to get this wig. I saw this wig, which is by Outre, and it's a lace front, and her name is Mystique. Now, I saw this wig, I think maybe last year. This was the time when I was trying to find that nice wavy, deep wave type of wig, and it was between Yasmin and Mystique, because I did see one video on Mystique. I liked it, but it just kind of looked so bulky and fat and thick, and it was cute, but I wasn't quite sure about it. It just looked like it was just too much hair that I had to, you know, fix. It was just too much. Like, I wasn't sure if I really wanted it. So that's when I turned to Estella by Outre. I said, oh, well, maybe this is the wig that I've been trying to get. And so when I saw a second video on Mystique, you know, sometimes you want to see more than one video. Sometimes you do, especially if you're like really not quite sure if you want the wig or not. So you at least want to know two videos, because you want to see a good video and a bad video. And usually you want to go with the good video for yourself. So I'm not saying that they both were bad. They both were good, just in different ways. And the only reason why that I got Mystique, because Black Spray, blackhairspray.com had a lace front Outre sale. All lace fronts were $19.99. So they all were exactly $19.99. So I got another Estella, because I love Estella. Even the other Estella is fine. Mystique, and I did get Balencia, but then I re-looked at the videos and I didn't like Balencia on anybody. So I said, okay, let me cancel that order. So I wrote to Black Hair Spray. I love blackhairspray.com because they have such great customer service. They are so fast with their shipping, and it was zero shipping. Okay, so like my price was fine. So I just got the two wigs for $19.99. And when I put this wig on, it reminded me of Estella, like a shorter, looser. This is like probably maybe 2 inches of a curling, of a curler. It is a curl, but it's like the big fat ones, and it's just laced up. Now, I love it. I think that this is more of a sophisticated wig. Like, you can wear it to work. Estella, you can't wear that to work. That's only if you want a sexual harassment suit on some person, because that wig is not for work, unless you're a stripper or a call girl. You know, you work in a club, stuff like that. That's what Estella's for. But this one is a little bit more reserved, but still on a really nice, pretty, you know, pretty girl bounce look. Pretty girl bounce, okay? For all the people that, I don't know why they put this, but it's 30 to 30, 300, let's fix this, 300 to 390 Fahrenheit of heat can go to this hair. I never curled any of my wigs. I straightened one of my wigs, which is a Zuri wig that I did, just to see what it looked like, because I didn't really like that wig anymore. So usually when I don't like a wig anymore, I kind of, you know, fix it up and see what I can do with it, and I flat iron it. But I don't see myself flat ironing this hair or curling this hair or any other wig that has heat resistant to it. Okay, but those are for the people that like to experiment on their wigs just as well. Now, the cap on this wig is very small, and I haven't done an update on my hair since I permed it, and my hair is at least maybe 16, I'll say maybe 16, between 14 and 16 inches, and my hair is thick, so I have like, it's kind of bulky back there, so I'm assuming maybe that's the reason why this is small, tighter, even though it is a small cap, but it's smaller because my hair is not braided. But I can say that the lace does lay down very nicely on it. Okay, this is the, well, I cut it off clearly, right? So this is the lace right here, and it lays down really nice. And what I like about Outre wigs, that they have the metal tabs on the side, so you can mold it to how you like it on the side of your head. If you didn't know that about Outre lace, which I'm really starting to love about Outre, okay. Outre, Freetress, and Sensational are my favorite brands right now as far as, you know, realistic looking hair. You know, I do like Friday night hair, but I feel like that hair is like really puffy and big. And I mean, that's like a really special occasion type of hair. I really like to just pop on a wig and look like I'm not trying that hard. And that's what I really like about Outre, Sensational, and Freetress's wig. So that's what I love about this hair. I just got it yesterday. They mailed it out on Monday because, of course, you know, New York got hit. Well, the East Coast got hit pretty hard from Hurricane Sandy. So a lot of shipments have been backed up. So I ordered this on Thursday. It would have came on Friday. But like I told you, a lot of deliveries were really just messed up. And the way that I'm going to keep up the wig, like I kept up with any of my other curly wigs, I use this Wet and Wavy Cream Moist curl cream. Now, I don't use it straight from the package here. I actually put it in a spray bottle with some water in it, and I just spray it on to the hair, because when I notice, even though it's not a really thick, but it does have this really weird texture to my hand and hair when I put it straight from here. Now, I'm going to just show you my favorite edge controls that I've been using lately since I've been relaxed with my hair, that's really been working for the front of my hair. The Weave Aid Straight Edge. And I had all these products. I didn't bring down the Black and Sassy. Actually, I thought this was the Black and Sassy. Clearly, it's the cocoa butter. I took the wrong one from upstairs. So, yeah. Let's pretend this is a Black and Sassy, because it does kind of look like a Black and Sassy package. But I do have the Black and Sassy for, what, like 2 years now since I started doing videos. I still have that. I still have the Weave Aid. Another product that I do use on my edges is the Lock Butter by Carol's Daughter. Now, I really love this stuff, especially right before I put my wig on. If I put my hair down in a bun, I really just put it on my edges and on my ends, and it molds it really, really nice. It doesn't, you know, shift out or anything. It keeps it really nice, soft, and sleek. And it also gives it that shine. So I'm going to show you exactly how long this wig is. Like I said, this is like the conservative version of Estella. So this is how long it is. I would say when you pull it, you know, as it gets older, it'll probably be around like 22 inches. But once it's in the front, I believe it's maybe around like 18 inches down and whatnot. So, but I did want to come to you guys. I know it's only 2 reviews, so I just wanted to show you guys another review how it is without pulling out the hair. And if you guys don't know, I always pull out my hair, but this wig is like my first lace front where I feel like I don't have to pull out the wig, because the hairline is so believable, and it looks really nice, neat, clean, and I really like it like this. So let me show you what it looks like in the front part. As you can see, it has its own zigzag. It's not like that straight part, because nobody really has a straight part. So I don't know if I'm going to rock it in the front or I'm going to rock it to the side, like how I, you know, sometimes do with most of my wigs. It can go to this side, it can go to that side. A lot of times, I haven't been complaining about a lot of hair that I got it. I got Freetress's Runway Girl, but I never showed you guys. But I just wanted to show you guys this wig and how much I do really love it, even with this outfit. This is just like a basic tee that I got from Wet Seal. And that's pretty much it, guys. This is a number 2. As you guys already know, I don't go as far as that, but I can see myself wearing this in the number 4. So one day I am going to explore a number 4 for you guys. One day. Not now, but one day. Okay, so thanks for watching, and let me know, comment below, and let me know what you think. Subscribe, guys. Peace. Sweeter than a swisher. Mad 'cause I'm cuter than the girl that's with you.